Hello and welcome. Today we discuss logistic regression. Just to take you a little bit back, we talked about dummy variables, but in the case of the dummy variables we discussed, all the dummy variables were predictor variables. Now, we look at the case where the response variable is a dummy variable, and that is where we apply logistic regression. Logistic regression, as I've said, is used when the response variable has an attribute of success or fail, and so can be defined using a dummy variable. Suppose we have a response variable that is dichotomous, that is, yi is either equal to 0 or 1. We would be interested mostly on the probability that y occurs versus the probability that y does not occur. The probability y occurs is equal to 1, and the probability y does not occur is the probability that y is equal to 0. So in this case, we denote pi to be the probability that y occurs. When we are modeling in using the logistic model, we actually don't model the probabilities. You will notice that while the variable y is 0 or 1, its probability will range between 0 and 1 and will be continuous variable, so it can take any value between 0 and 1. But to make it better and have a wider range, instead of modeling the probabilities, we model the odds. What are the odds that y occurs? The odds are given by the ratio of the probability that y occurs divided by the probability that y does not occur. And as you can see in this formula, we have pi, which is the probability y occurs, over 1 minus pi, probability y does not occur. This probability pi is computed using this formula, where now the probabilities are determined by the values of x1, x2. These are the predictor variables. They determine our probability pi. So we can now compute the odds ratio, and our odds ratio z is going to be equal to, when you do a little bit of mathematics, is going to be equal to this expression. But now, as you recall, in linear regression, we may not be able to model such an equation. Neither can we use ordinary least squares to estimate the parameters. So we first of all transform this one to a log linear model. And that model is known as the logistic model. And if we take logs on both sides, this is what we will get. Li is equal to this. Now you can see we have got a linear model on the right-hand side. So this is known as the logit model. And it is the one that we use to estimate the parameters of beta naught, beta 1, beta 2, all the way. And the error term, as usual, is going to cancel out. So what is the interpretation of these coefficients? It means that for beta I, it implies that if you increase xi by 1 unit, then the log odds ratio will increase by 100 e raised to beta I minus 1%. Or change by this amount. So e raised to beta I, because you remember we took the logarithm and then you subtract 1 so that you get the percentage. For the constant, it gives us e raised to beta naught, which is the value that was in the odds ratio, gives us the odds ratio of y occurring when all the predictors are absent. So now I want us to look at this using an example, and we will use Nancy's research data, which I posted on Moodle portal. Nancy was my student, and she did that. She fitted that model to her data when she was doing a study on default of loans among women self-help groups in Murang'a County. So let's get to Stata. So we first of all import the data. And here we get here Nancy data 2. And then we want to, we don't need row 1 up to 10. So we eliminate them and start at 11. Row 11 is giving us the variable names. So we import them as variable names. And then we say, okay. So this data, this is our data. And Nancy was modeling loan repayment, that either loan is repaid or not repaid against the group characteristics of group size, group composition, default rate, meetings, the number of meetings the group holds, workshops, and then the sanctions applied by the group. So let's see. So now for us to be able to fit the Logit model, we come to statistics and we come to binary and we select logistic regression. This one is the one we use because it is the one that helps us to compute the odds ratio. So we select that, and then our independent variable is loan. Our output variable is size. So we select all those, and then we need to come here at maximization and suppress this so that it doesn't waste a lot of time showing us the iterations. And then we say, okay. So here is the output that we have, and you can copy this output and take it to your Excel worksheet or take it to MS PowerPoint, or copy it directly to MS Word. I would advise you copy first of all to MS Excel, do a little bit of editing the table, then you copy it to Word. So now what we have here is that these are not our coefficients. What you're seeing here, these are not our coefficients. These are the odds ratios that we talked about. If we want to see the coefficients, we rerun this model. But this time, we run using logistic without, and we don't ask for the odds ratio. So we click logistic, we select loan, and then we select, not loan, it's not going to be one of them, sorry. So we're going to select group size, meetings. So there you are. Again, we have to suppress the iteration log, and then we say okay. And now you can see this table and this one are exactly the same, except that the coefficient, now here you have the coefficients, here you have the odds ratio. You can see odds ratio, these are the coefficients, they're the ones you will write in your model, and this is the, and these are the p-values, so you can see that your variables are that the coefficient for group size is not significant and group composition is not significant. The rest are significant. So you will see that the first one was the logistic and the second one is the logit command. If you look here, this is logistic that produced this. And the second one, this one is logit, which produces the coefficients. It's important you produce both so that you can connect them. But when we are going to write the equation, we use this. But interpretation, we will refer to the odds ratio. And let's get back now to our PowerPoint and see what happens. So here we have the output for the logistic regression. And these are the odds ratios. These are the odds ratios. And these are their standard errors and the p-values. Okay. So in this case, if you want to get the odds ratio, you have to take e raised to power. So like now, if you take e to power 1.059186, you will not that one, sorry. We first of all get the logit model, and here is the logit. So if you take e raised to this power here, e raised to power 0.0575008, you will get this value, and you can attempt that one. So if we take this, let me go back. So if you take this, here, and we can attempt that. So if we bring back our output now, this one, e raised to this power is equal to this. And you can try all these others. E raised to this power will give you this. These are the odds ratio. Okay? These are the odds ratio. And this is the output for the logit model. And here we note that only this one and this coefficient are not significant. But when you're writing the equation, you use the logit regression model. So this is the way our equation will look like. And these are obtained from the output of the logit regression model. From this output and from what we have seen up there, the model is useful in predicting the odds ratio of the loan default. So you'll see here, this is the F value. Here is the chi-square, and you have got the p-value is 0.000, which is less than 0.05, which means that overall, the model is useful in predicting the log odds ratio. but you don't interpret the pseudo r. It is not the same as r squared. That is just put there. It has no meaning for us. Let's look at the coefficients. And for the coefficients, we noted that all the coefficients are significant except for group size and group composition, which have p-values equal to 0.053, and this one p-value equal to 0.276, which is less than 0.05. And so how do we interpret them? For example, if we look at the workshops coefficient, it means that for every workshop attended, the odds ratio of defaulting a loan increases by 6.79 minus 1%, which is equal to 59.79%. So for every workshop attended, the loan default increases. So that is an interesting finding. Now, when we look at another case where the coefficient is negative, a unit increase in the group sanctions SET leads to 0.611 minus 1% increase, which is equal to 38.9%. That is 38.9% decrease, because now the sign here is negative. When you subtract one, it means that for every unit increase in group sanctions, then the default rate decreases by 38.9%, which means then the group sanctions work. So if we go back here to the model, this model, what you will notice is that when you want to interpret, you take the odds ratio and subtract one. Like this one, it would mean that if we increase, although this is not significant, let's pick something, okay, let's just interpret this one. If you subtract one, it would mean that if you increase group size by one unit, then the loan default rate would increase by 1.059 minus 1, which is equal to 5.9%. And so on. So you can work out on the others. The only one you don't interpret in a similar manner is the constant. The constant, this one indicates the odds ratio of defaulting when all these other variables are absent. So that is it for the our discussion on the logistic regression. It was good to have you. Have a good day. Bye-bye.